Ugh, I hate Donald Trump so much. But I also hate Hillary too. I think I'll vote for Jill Stein.
Now, particularly to Bernie fans, Jill Stein might seem like a good option at this year's presidential election. Jill Stein is a badass female, she's the leader of the Greens, and she's one of the most popular candidates behind Hillary and Trump. And she's a huge supporter of universal healthcare. That's something that I'm really passionate about. Now, I looked at Ms. Stein's Dr. Stein's policies because I wanted to endorse her too. But as a scientist, I have some really big, important concerns about Jill Stein as a president of the United States that I think that you should know about too. So here's some of my concerns. Jill is a medical doctor and a researcher, so we thought that she'd be a huge advocate of good science. Au contraire. Well, she's not as bad as Dr. Carson, who's also a medical doctor with some beliefs that are clearly not based on scientific consensus. She does have a few dodgy ideas. So let's have it. One of the things that she's a little sketchy on is vaccines. Here's what she said.
As a medical doctor, there was a time where I looked very closely at those vaccination issues, and not all those issues were completely resolved.
Issues not resolved? Yes, they have been resolved. Now, one of the things that she's been questioning is the vaccine schedule, or the age at which we give vaccines to children. That's the same criticism that Donald Trump raised when he tweeted, "Tiny children are not horses." Like, obviously. The thing is, all aspects of vaccines have been carefully and thoroughly tested. The reason we vaccinate kids when they're young is because that's when their bodies are actively building their defenses against everything in the world. And any delays to vaccinating children against serious diseases leave them at risk. Science has proven this in literally thousands of studies. So I'm surprised that Jill Stein doesn't agree. On the topic of homeopathy, Jill Stein and the Greens Party support the teaching, funding, and practice of homeopathy, which is bull. Homeopathy doesn't work, as proven in, again, literally thousands of scientific studies. Supporting something that doesn't work is pretty bad for a presidential candidate. But the thing is, many young children who've been exposed to homeopathic treatments suffer hugely. Now, she's a huge critic of nuclear power. This year she tweeted,
"Nuclear power plants equals weapons of mass destruction waiting to be detonated."
But the thing is, there's actually a really big difference between the nuclear products used and produced through nuclear power plants and that used in nuclear weapons. This kind of shows a fundamental misunderstanding of nuclear energy and how it works. Pretty incredible for a presidential candidate who campaigns on energy as her key policy position.
But how could someone who graduated from Harvard Medical School be so bad at science?
Well, it's probably a case of niche politics. So she's part of the Greens Party, and so she has to talk about the things that Green voters think about. Dr. Stein also wants to decrease funding on space exploration because where has NASA ever gotten us? Only the moon. Ban GMOs until they've been proven safe. They have been proven safe repeatedly. Seriously, people, how many f***ing studies do you need until you're happy? And ban Wi-Fi in schools because of health concerns. If there's health concerns around Wi-Fi, we're all f***ed. I'm personally freaking annoyed that Dr. Stein is so anti-science because I think she has some really awesome policy positions, like a cleaner environment and better healthcare for everyone and racial justice. But ethically, I just can't encourage you guys to vote for someone that has such illogical and, like, frankly dangerous views on science. Like her or not, Hillary is the only big name candidate who's in line with the scientific majority. Like I've mentioned in previous videos, everyone is entitled to their opinion. But on scientific facts, there is no excuse for the type of ignorance that we're seeing from Dr. Stein. But what do you guys think? Would you like to vote for Jill Stein? Is there one particular thing that's grating on you that would make you vote for someone else? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below.
Hi everyone, I'm Jayde Lovell, resident science nerd on the Young Turks Network. You're watching SciQ and we know you don't want to miss an episode, so please click the subscribe button down below.